We are your local election headquarters, and we do want to make sure you're as prepared as possible for the November election. It's very important that you get out and vote, but we invited all three candidates for Midland Mayor to be on our show throughout this week.
And today we are joined by candidate Patrick Payton, and tomorrow we'll have candidate Jenny Cudd, and unfortunately incumbent Mayor Jerry Morales won't be able to make it on our show, but kicking off the interviews today, we have Mr. Payton, thank you so much for being
with us. Great to be here. Great to be here on a cold, cold day.
I know. And waking up so early with us, we really appreciate having you here. What is one point that's very important to you as a part of your campaign, your platform?
Well, the main part is people have asked us to be engaged in this process for leadership. They've also asked us to be a part of a transparency movement and also really a vision towards our future in Midland, and it also includes the entire basin. And as we were talking about really before the broadcast, the importance of how you only have 5 days to vote. And so today, the rest of the week, and then next week, and all those people out there who say, you know what, we're going to wait until next Tuesday, oftentimes things get in the way. So it's a big campaign that's been going on with a lot of candidates and a lot of issues. And so right now, they've heard us as candidates talking for quite some time, and now we're hoping people get out and vote.
What's one thing that you wish someone would ask you that you might have not had a chance to address at some of these meetings or some of these panels?
Well, you know what? We've had a lot of questions asked. That's a hard question to say. I wish there was one more question someone could ask. Really, the best thing that's happened to us is as we've traveled around the city of Midland, we've done what's called listening tours. And we've had various stops all over north, south, and east, and west Texas, or Midland, and we've been able to hear a lot of questions. People have been able to feel free to talk to us and feel free to say, what about this issue? What about this issue? It's more than just roads. It's more than just infrastructure. They want to talk about transparency. They want to talk about accountability. They want to talk about low taxes. And so just going around town talking to people, I can't really think of a question I wish someone would ask, because I think we've been asked just about everything down to what our favorite restaurant is last night on a Facebook Live.
I love that. The Facebook Lives, they can get a little wild, but along with transparency, I know a hot button topic out here is infrastructure, especially when it comes to roads and foundations for new companies that are making their way out here. What's your plan for that?
We're going to sit down with as many people as we possibly can to find a long-term solution for our roads and infrastructure, not just something that's immediate. We have to realize as a community, both Midland and Odessa, how in the last 3 or 4 years, we've really, no pun intended, been literally run over. And so we're really playing from behind and trying to catch up. But I think what the taxpayers want to hear is not, are we just going to have one more bond, but do we have a 6-year plan, a 10-year plan, so that we know where we're going? Because it's still going to take us some time to catch up, and we're going to have to work through the cycles of our economy as well. I think everybody has seen a little bit of an adjustment taking place, but we as the city are still going to have to plan for consistent growth and make sure we show the taxpayers how we're going to pay for it and how we can stay out of debt as we pay for it.
And also involving infrastructure, what other hot topics are ones that you would focus on right away if you became mayor?
Well, the first thing we're going to have to do is get inside City Hall and look at the budget line by line. I think people want to see, is money being spent well? Tell us how money is being spent, and tell us how you're going to spend money, and not just at the end of the year tell us how you spent our tax dollars. I think there's a lot of people who want to hear greater transparency. One of the things we're going to do in regards to that is try to move city council meetings to 5 o'clock in the evening so people don't have to take off work at 10 o'clock in the afternoon. You can say you want to be accountable and transparent, but when people have to take off work to come to your meetings, that's a little bit difficult for them to see what's going on. And people want to be there and voice their opinions and voice their concerns.
It's definitely
very,
a struggle.
Very true.
Yeah, with the timing. But also, too, I'm curious to know what your leadership style is as mayor. What would that look like for people?
Well, I really like to get people around the table who disagree. I like to get people around the table who are willing to have hard discussions and ask hard questions. As many of my friends will tell you, he's not afraid to ask you questions, and you're going to be mad at him in a meeting, but you'll be fine afterwards. And I think that's how you make progress. We sit down across the table. We make sure what each other's objectives are, what each other's values are. We put those out in prioritized order, and then we show them to the taxpayers. We just make sure we're having the hard meetings and the hard discussions, and we're not letting people tell us what we're not doing favors for people because they're big donors or anything like that. But we're doing what's best for the community. We're asking hard questions and getting as many people involved as we can so that we can have the best input to make the best decision for the long-term good of the city.
And as a taxpayer yourself, I think this is probably the final question, but What is important to you as far as what you want to invest in, where you want to see your taxpayer dollars going?
Well, I want to make sure there's a good, consistent plan for our roads and our infrastructure. Those are the big things people are asking us about. And then I just want to make sure you're spending the money well, and I'm not surprised by some kind of crazy spending idea. As long as there's fiscal discipline, conservative use of our tax dollars, and people know what's happening, I think they'll be satisfied with their elected officials.
Well, thank you so much for being here.
You're very welcome.
Great information, especially for our voters. We want to get them as prepared as possible. So, Mr. Payton, thank you again for being
here. Very welcome. Thank you for having me.
And for more information, you can check out his Facebook page as well, and other information we'll have on our website. But we'll be right back with more news and weather after a quick commercial break. You're watching Good Morning Basin.